Okay, we are back with more 15.
Yeah. So, you've camped.
Yes. I camped and I got just I think Tails does this, right? You cook food and you get like stat boosts.
Yeah, it was actually
Tails of Games. I mean you cook like on the fly, you don't cook at a campsite. But
yes, you do. Yeah, you do, and you can cook items and they're healing items.
Right.
Freaking so, Muramasa actually kind of did the same thing with cooking.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So, you see at the bottom of the screen on Noct's foot right there, I have a little sword icon.
Yes.
That's the stat boost I got from cooking.
Okay, so hold on. Where is the gas station?
We can't see it from here, but it's over here. It's to the east.
So, you guys freaking carried your chairs and tent and cooler from there to like a half mile away.
No, we have the interdimensional weapon hyperspace.
Oh, okay, okay.
I didn't mention it before, but Noctis uses it to carry his fishing gear too.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's a third of a mile away.
Yeah. Every one of the bros has a social like kind of skill they do.
Uh-huh.
So Prompto does photography, Ignis does cooking, and Gladiolus does survival, which seems to be he like finds like shit, like items and shit for you out in the wilderness.
Okay.
And Noctis is fishing because he apparently really likes to fish. So when you find a fishing point, and you activate it, he like waves his hand and his fishing rod appears. I see shit like that is kind of why I like Noctis.
So couldn't he just, for example, go, man, I really could use a cold one. Boom. Ah.
Theoretically, I mean, we're carrying ingredients and shit to cook things on, so maybe we do that. Oh, here's something kind of dumb. So, number one, I hate it when games have, like, limit the amount of time you can run when it's an open world game like this.
Yeah.
I hate these stamina systems. Here's a weird thing that I don't know why it exists in the game. So, if you run until your stamina is almost out, you can... I messed up. Let me do one more try.
Okay.
There you go. So we run until stamina is almost out, and then we do... And we just auto-refill it.
Wait, what? What did you do?
If you just let go of the button right when it hits the S, and then you hit it, and then... If you let go of the button, then you just get your stamina recharged. So you can, like, sprint indefinitely, but...
So they could have just given you unlimited stamina, but...
Yeah.
They decided to make a game of it.
I don't know why. And, like, there's an auto-sprint, which I have on right now, but you can't do the stamina trick if you auto-sprint, so it's basically useless.
Huh.
There are parts of some of the outposts I've been to, where when you're in, like, a restaurant, and they don't want you to be running full tilt, because, I guess, like, you know, realism or something.
Right.
So... So sprinting in those instances lets you run basically at normal speed, and so you can auto sprint in those to just kind of like move without being at a frustratingly slow pace. But
okay,
it's dumb. Basically, is what I'm getting at. I found some daggers. So each of the bros has uses two kinds of weapons. Gladiolus will use two-handed swords and shields. Ignis will use daggers and also spears.
All right.
And Prompto will use guns and machinery.
Wait, okay, look. Hold on, go back to Prompto there.
Yeah.
Now we can take a good look. See, it is not, yeah.
It's not a skirt, but it's like a weird, like attachment
his
to his
jacket.
His jacket
has extension flaps on it, which...
I guess it gives him like wind resistance?
For added protection from...
Also, we can take off the jacket. Oh, you're right. It is part of the jacket.
Yeah, the jacket has wings.
His jacket is dumb. We can also put him in casual wear, where he looks even stupider.
Well, at least I don't hate his boots there.
And casual wear with no jacket, where he's just a fashion
model. And he has cloud hair.
Yeah. Fun fact.
But look at his stupid boots, though.
Fun fact, when Prompto was a kid, he was a fat nerd.
Really?
Yeah, his episode of the anime is like... is basically getting told by the princess to be Noctis' friend, so he like exercises and trains for like for the rest of middle school so he can become a bishy by the time he's in high school.
Huh.
And then he becomes his friend. It's kind of weird.
Look out. Yeah, it looks pretty tame.
Yeah, that's why that evil aura is coalesced on its face. Gladiolus is the coolest. Prompto's still kind of a shithead.
Oh, was that a...
That was a warp point. So,
okay.
The warp strike lets you teleport to an enemy, and if you do it right, you can also like break parts of them off, like in Monster Hunter.
Okay. Neat.
Also, the farther you travel to the enemy, the more damage you do.
Okay, makes sense. You must be accelerating, even though you're teleporting. Never mind. Doesn't make sense.
And if you attack an enemy directly from behind, you get a blindside attack. Which is, it's like a backstab in Dark Souls.
Okay, so critical hit.
Yeah, and if you're using the right kind of enemy, or if you're using the right kind of weapon, then your buddies will also join in, and you'll do a link strike.
Okay, so he used the strategy was he used Tempest.
Well, the strategy was for him to use Tempest. I was chaining.
Did another warp point appear there? I saw something blinking up there.
Yeah, there's one up there. They don't appear, they're just on the battlefield by default.
Oh, so you can, you have a limited amount which you can use in a fight?
No, they're just always there.
Oh, so you can reuse the same one multiple times?
Yeah, exactly.
So wait, doesn't that kind of open the windows to sort of a spammy teleport around strategy?
No, because teleporting takes a lot of MP.
Oh, I forgot that it costs MP.
And right. It also costs stamina. If your stamina runs out while you're hanging on a point, you'll just fall down.
Okay, there you go. See, that's the reason, because
there's a lot of mitigating factors.
In what I
I haven't gotten into it because I don't really use it too much, but there is actually an auto dodge button, more or less. If you hold down the square button, Noctis will phase through any attacks that come his way.
At the cost of MP, I hope.
Yeah, every single one you dodge drains a chunk of your MP.
There
is a part of the skill tree that will reduce how much it takes, and there's also one that adds like a perfect dodge kind of thing, where if you dodge right when the attack's about to hit you, it's free.
Okay.
So cool. it's not nearly as abusable as it sounds.
All right.
So we got to do a lot of walking right here, which is about to end, thankfully, because once you have the car, you can automatically teleport back to the car from any point.
You know what I realized? That as long as your MP is full, you might as well at least teleport once to travel per full MP bar, you know?
I mean, I feel like the animation's, like, probably eaten to how much time it takes.
Okay.
I don't know.
I mean, I don't know. I would, like, if it was me, I would teleport, and when that MP got to full again, I'd teleport again. Just for long distance crap, but I mean, it doesn't really matter. Whoa. The eagle. Or not eagle. That thing's like half bird, half storm, half airship. You realize indeed. That's three halves.
Let it explain its size. See?
It's 50% bird, 50% terror, 50% awe.
I think one of the things that keeps Prompto in check is that when he's a shithead, people call him on it. Like, people treat him appropriately, and that helps me to kind of like Prompto.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't get away with being a shithead. Except when he sings the damn song. He's also really into chocobos for some reason.
I mean, he is a... Well, in our universe, we have horses and we are equestrian, you know, lovers. But in... What would you call people that like chocobos recreationally?
Avianesters?
I'll go with it.
You know, you just made me think of something.
Huh.
Do you think there's like a My Little Chocobo
like
kind of show in this universe?
Definitely.
And there are like chonies.
Yep.
Like as the fans.
And freaking Rainbow Chocobo would be my waifu there too.
Actually, I mean, if we want to be accurate, I'm sure the name would actually be Chocobros.
Yeah, that's true. Or chocobronies.
Well, pony isn't part of the word chocobo.
Well, so. Oh yeah, you're right.
Oh, and I'm missing out on a chest over here.
Oh, look at that. It's on the mini-map.
Yeah.
Can you look at... On the larger map, do those icons appear?
Yeah, and more... Well, see,
where's the chest?
It would be there if I had talked to the tipster.
Oh, I gotcha.
Yeah, but I screwed up on
so
that.
So things are on the minimap regardless of tipster usage.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, I talk to all the tipsters in my main playthrough, so I haven't really had to see that.
I see.
But yeah. That's something that's kind of annoying, that like you can push your guys around by accident and they all get mad. Or like if you pull your weapon out when they're around, they'll be like, "Hey, watch where you're swinging that thing." And it's like, guys, like you can't take damage.
How many times do you need to write the word diner on it? Wait, hammer diner?
Yeah. Well, this outpost is called like Hammer Point, I think it is.
But yeah, hammer diner is written several times there.
Because this is the diner at Hammer Point.
Well, right, but once is good.
Welcome. So see, we talked to the tipster. And he has very intimate knowledge of all the
stuff. Of the local stuff, landscape. Yeah. All right.
And the parking spaces.
Wow. Wow.
See, this is all the stuff I missed out on.
Wait, what are those? Okay. Well, we'll see later.
Yeah. And see, those,
so you're going to ask
is,
about monsters?
This is also where you pick up your hunts. So I might do like one, like just to show you like, but
okay.
For the most part, if we kept doing this, I would do the hunts off screen, if at all, because they're really boring.
All right.
It's just go here, kill a thing.
Yeah, they were pretty boring in 12 as well.
And 13 also. But people love the hunts in 12 and 13. Check out my pimped out ride.
Whoa. Wait, did you... What? Did you ask for that or did you just do that?
This is something that's kind of weird. I don't think this is intended. But see, I got this Chocobo like paint job as a DLC thing. And for whatever reason, the game automatically applies it when Cindy fixes up the car. I think it might just be a coding thing, like replacing the broken car with the fixed car or something
Cindy's
like that.
Cindy's just like, I'm working for Frey, I pick the paint job.
Yeah. Ain't she pretty?
She's almost too pretty for the road. Put a shirt on, Cindy.
No. Apparently, if you bought the game through the Square Enix store, you got a Cindy like paint job for the car. Well, it's like Cindy and Carbuncle. Oh, we didn't get the message this time.
All right.
So
Prompto's my favorite. I'm sorry.
Something that was funny about this.
What's up?
I think I told you about this, but when I played the Platinum demo, I'm assuming that he becomes important later on, but Carbuncle plays a big role in the Platinum demo.
Okay.
And at the end of the Platinum demo, it tells you to name your Esper buddy. And so, like, I really hated this version of Carbuncle, so in protest, I named him Doomtrain, because Doomtrain is the coolest Esper ever,
even though
he's from the shittiest game. So, when you first boot up 15, it was like, hey, you did, it was like, I'll do the drum. It was like, hey, you finished the Platinum demo. Now your best friend Doomtrain will join you on your adventures.
Oh, man, cool.
And for a second, I was like, oh, man! And I thought, oh, wait a second.
Yeah.
I remembered the reason. And I got sad. So, fuck you, Carbuncle. Doomtrain forever. So, I just want to show you this really quick. Here's the driving in the game.
Dude, the inside, though. All right, that's pretty pimp.
You can customize it, too. You can customize the interior.
Wait, what the hell is happening? Oh, that's...
They're taking the hood down.
Oh, that's... Okay, that's interesting.
So, here's the driving for this game. It sucks. It's really, really
shitty. Wait, how do you go into third-person mode, please?
That's just how it is.
Please tell me there's...
Well, we're in third-person mode.
No, I mean, how do I go into farther...
This is it.
No, I don't want this.
This is it. We also can't drive off-road. And
you can't zoom out at least.
Nope. I'm pretty sure this is as far as you can go. And if you want to like do a U-turn, you just like have to hit a button because your car isn't maneuverable enough to do it.
Oh wow! I mean, that was pretty maneuverable. Or was that?
That was the U-turn button.
Oh. Okay.
And like, it's
Wait,
really
does the button work if you're standing still?
I think you just like drive forward a bit. It just does it for you basically. Okay. So the driving is almost worse than it.
Wait, dude, spam the U-turn button and do donuts.
I mean, it's not really like
Dude,
this is like kind of the best we can do.
Oh, it doesn't. It's.
I'm just mashing it.
All right, never. Oh wait, that's cool.
So driving sucks, but thankfully you can. Thankfully, Noctis does most of the driving for you.
Okay.
You can just tell him to drive you to a place, and he'll do it.
All right.
Nate. Which is nice. And then we're gonna pull back in here, and I forget. Do I have Gil yet? You're being helpful for a change. As soon as everyone
so
finishes.
I have found.
Yes, I do. So I'm gonna get a refill on my car. Right, as soon as I. Let's get some service here.
Oh God. Can you get a car wash with that too?
Maybe. And now the important part.
Oh, good. I see. No, you want to get those windows clean.
Yeah. Totally worth the 10 gil. 100 gil, whatever I paid for it.
It's like, yeah, that's the amount of gil.
I like to think that the guys were just watching the whole time. So, here's something cool. You can go to the shops, and you can buy the soundtracks for other Final Fantasy games.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. So we're going to buy 4. I guess I'll buy 8.
And then 6?
I haven't found 6 yet. I've gotten 5, 10, 4, 8. I want to say like one more? What the hell. I'll do like one of the easy hunts right now just to show you.
Okay.
Why I'm not going to be doing any more of these.
Take your pick.
So we'll do this level 2 hunt.
Okay.
It's against some of those wolf things.
The Howling Wind of Hunger.
Yep. They all have neat names like that, if nothing else.
So if you beat him, then do starving children get some, you know, food?
I don't know what you're referencing.
Well, you're beating hunger.
Oh. No. Because these are just like the winds of hunger. Like the winds of destruction.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the high potion.
Yep. I'm keeping an eye out for those little sparkly things because I want to get some scrap metal if I can. And I think it's random, like, when you come across that. It just seems to be like a thing you find in towns.
So wait, you can't go off-road, so you can't just drive the car out there?
Nope. That's why Phantasy Star 4 will always be the superior car driving RPG. I got some metal scrap.
Okay, wait,
because,
so maybe...
Because in Phantasy Star 4, if you'll recall, when they gave you a vehicle, it was a fucking tank, and you could, like, shoot lasers at monsters.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was literally the best. Like, you can't beat that.
So, freaking... So this is why they have chocobos, because the vehicles aren't designed...
Yeah, exactly.
Their foolish wheels cannot handle... the dirt and foliage.
The car can somehow get dirty?
I know.
I don't know how it can, because I know that Cindy offers like to fix up your car if it's damaged or dirty. I'm assuming damaged happens if you drive around at night.
So wait, what is that fourth option on what's down on your D-pad?
That's the fire spell I crafted.
Oh, cool. Wow, that's neat.
Yeah. But it's got a cooldown.
Oh yeah, I haven't seen you use that lance.
I never use lances. I don't really like them. Oh, something that is kind of neat about the magic is that they have environmental effects. So that's like a burning patch and things that...
Oh, anyone that walks over it?
Yeah, anyone that walks over it will get burnt.
Can you get hurt by your own?
I don't know. I rolled through it, but you're normally invincible when you're doing stuff like that.
Oh, this guy's tough.
Yeah. Hey, I should switch. And I should also be using my dudes.
So where is your health? Because I see the other three.
It's in the bottom corner.
There it is. Oh, yeah. No, yeah. I wasn't looking up there.
I like Ingus's starting technique for this first stretch because it's multi-hit.
Oh, cool.
But I tend to replace it pretty quickly because... I mean, I'm not a master at this game yet, but it seems like Ignis has all, like, the really good upgrades, like, at the onset.
Okay.
Because, do I have skills? I have AP to spend. So, like, I had to get his beginning one, which is he scans enemies sometimes, which is, I don't really like this system because if you don't have the wait mode enabled, you can't see enemy weaknesses. Really? So the scanning does nothing for you. Yeah, you have to go into wait mode if you want to see his enemies. If you want to see enemy weaknesses, and it's really annoying.
Huh.
Once I get some more AP, I'll be able to get him his healing ability, which is of course really handy.
Right.
So now that I've done the hunt, I can just teleport back to my car.
Oh, is that just a feature of hunts?
Yeah. Okay. Well, no, that's just a feature. Period. You can also teleport back to the last place you rested at.
So you can always just fast travel to car wherever you are?
Yeah, wherever you are.
And as many times as you want?
Yep.
All right.
If your car gets stuck, like you run out of gas, you can also give Cindy a call on your phone, and she'll tow it for you.
So, oh, cool.
For a nominal fee. I'm assuming. It's never actually happened to me. And you can also just call your car to a place. I haven't had to do that.
This is... another, it sounds to be like Deadly Premonition in another aspect, where you can run out of gas and then have to get towed, and then.
But see, in Deadly Premonition, like those were things that impacted your game for like kind of a reason,
right?
Whereas in here, like if you run out of gas, you just call Cindy and you know she fixes it for you. Like it's, I also don't really like the whole driving around at night thing for the same reason that. It's not in a survival game. It would punish you for driving around at night. But in here, like everyone just starts whining, like Noctis, let's not drive around at night. And then you can just like teleport back home. Like it's weird and dumb.
Huh.
Anyway, let's drive around our automobile.
Clear skies with the temperature rising.
So in my experience, I see absolutely no benefit to driving around with the top down in a convertible.
I mean, it lets you see their flowing hair.
Because every time I've been in a convertible twice.
Yeah, it's just like a thing people like to do.
And on one time, stuff blew in my face because there are no protection around me. You know, something that cars, a handy feature of cars. And the other time, nothing blew in my face, but it was just hot as hell, and nothing shields me from the sun.
Yeah, I've never.
So I.
Yeah, I've never been in a convertible, but it just seems like it'd be annoying.
Yeah, and it really, I mean, it seems to be one of those things that's entirely done for the perceived coolness factor.
Listen to the soundtrack.
Oh, look at that! That's cool.
Yeah, I have the.
I guess being able to do that is kind of handy.
Yeah, it is.
Like suddenly hit the brakes. Does he fly?
I can't.
Oh.
I can. All right. Well.
Oh, and he did. He's like he lurched.
That's actually kind of funny.
That's cool. So if you were driving, would somebody else sit up like that?
I don't think they actually sit up like that. Oh, can I? Resume. Yeah, I don't. I mean, they do different things, like why aren't we? Are we going? Hello, no, Ignis.
What's going on? Accelerate R2.
Over a sec.
I'm just gonna hop back in.
Oh, okay.
Like Ignis will like drink cans of coffee, and like Gladiolus will like read books.
All right.
And shit.
Dude, that gold steering wheel is the pimpin'.
Yeah.
Like, that is cool.
Yeah, I've gotten, like, other paint jobs, and I'm just... it's the Chocomobile. Like, I'm...
Yeah.
It's the Chocobrobile. Like, I'm just not gonna change.
All right, I want you to deliberately ram into another car that's
You can't.
Arr.
I tried it. You just, like... Either they just kind of get nudged out of the way, or you just stop until they move. Like,
Rawr.
The driving is extremely bare bones, so... There's really no point in driving manually, and thankfully now we can't until, like, Chapter 3.
Huh.
Unless you're driving at night. Ignis will not drive at night for reasons.
Okay.
Oh, here's something fun. So, over here, because this is, like, Texas, we have one of these, like, little diner...
Yeah, diner,
like,
diner.
Dudes.
We have a diner.
Yes. And so I can sit here, and Prompto will take the picture.
That map mascot right there is the kind of thing that looks fine during the day.
Yeah.
But if you were here by yourself at night, you would poo your pants.
It looks like
so bad.
It looks like something from, like, Don't Hug Me, I'm Scared.
Just imagine. Like, turn around. Watch this. Okay. Go around the corner. Go left around the corner. Just go around the diner, all right? So imagine it's dark. Okay, nobody's here. Just walk out slowly. You're just walking. Okay, just keep walking. Don't walk over the red car. Don't even look, right? And then you just innocuously turn to the left. And it's just like, hey, buddy! I'd be like, no!
Yeah.
I wouldn't, no.
I mean, the picture's gonna be cute.
Yeah, definitely. Deliver the goods. Thank you kindly.
We'll take it out of the trunk, so you all just sit tight. Thank you for not making me walk all the way back to the trunk.
Dog. It's a doggy.
This is Luna Freya's dog.
Oh, that's a cool dog.
Yeah.
It actually kind of looks like Link is a wolf, like a wolf pup.
So I guess they have this, like, thing they do where, like, Luna Freya sends the dog to find Noctis with, like, a book with messages written in it. And then, like, Noctis just, like, writes back. And the dog is just running, like, all over the country.
The dog's just the courier?
Dog's just running all over the country. How did the dog even find us?
He's got a scent. Did you see that MythBusters episode where...
Incidentally, this is the version of Noctis you play as in the Platinum demo.
Oh, okay.
Child Noctis. He looks kind of like Johnny Yong Bosch.
Take the notebook with I don't know if it's just her hair, but she looks a lot older than Noctis.
No, they're the same age. I mean, I assume. Every Final Fantasy character, like, protagonist is between 16 and 18.
Yeah.
Because that's how things...
But no, yeah, there was that MythBuster episode where they tried to...
So see, I can write... She wrote to me
She
was leaving the place, and I can just be a dick, or be, like, neutral, or just, like, be really sappy.
Okay.
I think one of the things that helps me like Noctis is that I can control how he responds to a lot of things.
Yeah, I mean, you being able to define his personality is always an easy in for a player.
But also, I feel like he tends to... I mean, we won't be seeing any of it till later, but I feel like he tends to react to things a lot more realistically than other Final Fantasy protagonists who tend to be, like, obnoxiously upbeat about everything, like Tidus.
Yeah.
Or, like, incredibly, like, you know, Squall.
Yeah.
Just Squall.
Freaking... People like Squall. All the girls that like Squall, when you tell them he's an emo git, their response is just, but he's hot, though.
And I guess to, you know, people with no standards, he probably is. The gunblade is really cool until you put, like, a modicum of thought into it.
Yeah.
So there are also these quests where they just give you a search area and you have to find the person or the object you're looking for.
Okay, pretty standard quest fare.
Yeah. Thankfully, this guy's right here. Not really old
boys. Anyway, no, yeah, the dog nose can't be beat. MythBusters tried to throw off a bloodhound's
scent tracking. But there's, like, desert. Like a jillion miles of desert and Texans.
What they did, I remember what they did in the MythBusters episode
and
is...
And the demons of it.
They put a guy in a biohazard suit. In case you forget who you are. Chemically washed the biohazard suit with bleach and other things. And then sent the guy off into the hiding in the bush somewhere, and the dog was able to find it. So, as long as there's a molecule of scent left, they'll get you.
Yeah, well, that's interesting. If y'all happen to find any tags lying around out there. So this guy just introduces us to a series of quests where we run into him at, like, every other truck stop or so. And he says, hey, can you find this dog tag for me? And we find him the dog tag. Presumably, if you do, like, all of them, you get shit. You get, like, an ultimate something or other.
Wait, what is that? Look at that dog. Like, that animal he has looks like half a dog lying there. Looks oh no!
That's all dog.
It's just weirdly proportioned.
Yeah, there's no looking. There's no first person look, unfortunately. Which is a shame, because there's lots of neat stuff to look at here. Heavy stuff. They
certainly carry emotional weight. This setting looks like the location that they did the music video for. what was that song by Kesha? Take It Off?
I never saw that.
Yeah,
video,
I figured you wouldn't, but
I'll take your word for it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's an E. I was gonna say, look, it says Motil, but that's just it's a really shitty O and a really shitty E.
Motil. Yeah.
All right. Well, we should cut the video off.
Oh, look at the O on front is the same. That's just their dumb O font.
Yeah, it's a stupid font.
Anyway, yeah, so we may or may not do more of this. But anyway, that was a look at 15, which is the new hotness. So, yeah.
If you like it, let us know.
Or we might just do it regardless. I don't know.